great to have the opportunity to feature a student from the band and the solo. So, Mr. Jack Reinhardt, help us out.
job, Jack.
Jack, are you really a sophomore? Oh my gosh! What a tremendous job! Don't be afraid to really pour the air into that thing, okay? Here again, the melodic line. It's all when the line goes up, you feel a natural crescendo. When it comes down, feel a natural crescendo. But I think you could even put more air into the instrument and to really, really, really make those lines just sail. I mean, oh my gosh, I cannot believe you're a sophomore and playing that well. Oh, I remember when I was a sophomore, I didn't come close to that. Very, very nicely job. Done. Ensemble, make sure that you don't cover up the solos, okay? I know you're doing your best to play your parts and, you know, do exactly what the page says, but Jack is going to even put more air into that thing. He's really going to make those lines sail. So we're going to ask you to back off sometimes, and so that way we have more of a balanced sound. That way he doesn't feel like he's competing with you in order to get the job done. But what a beautiful, beautiful background. Jack, what a beautiful sound. I'm a saxophone player, and I'm here to tell you, you certainly, I couldn't do that when I was sophomore. That's the end of that, okay? Great job. A sophomore in college? Jack, you impressed me as being one with the horn. It just, I couldn't separate the two of you, just one. And the band, I felt you were part of that too. If I had a dance partner, I would have danced.
It's a good thing you don't. Okay, Mr. Piggy. Awesome. Really, really nice. Just and I agree 100% with the fact that the ensemble, you're giving him a run for his money, volume-wise a little bit. You guys have to stay way, 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 way down. And having that said that, though, there are a couple of spots where the balance within the accompaniment line, I think, could be tweaked a little bit. One of the little tiny spots is 5 and 6 after A. If you've got an eighth rest followed by 3/4 notes, that line needs to come out a little bit within the ensemble. And 3 before D, I'd like to hear a lot more of the lower clarinets there, just within that little section. Nice work, guys.
Wow. You know, your head should be exploding right now, because it's just really, really awesome. It's just, I can't believe, when he said you were a sophomore, I'm like, you know, I thought at his age he was sort of like senile or something, but no, Jack, that was absolutely wonderful. Now, everybody's talking about the same thing. I was going to mention about the rest, 3/8 notes, that moving, be-doo-dee-dum, that line right there. You have that several times, and it gets lost, and that would help stabilize the band parts when they come in. That being said, remember, I know that you have a great jazz tradition in your school. Okay, a good jazz thing to think about is that when the soloist is in front and doing the solo, you've got to act like the soloist is sitting right next to you. If you can't hear it, then the audience can't either. So keep that in mind right there. When you get down to Grand Rapids, to the auditorium down there, DeVos is just, it's a really nice place to be at. But remember to look up more and really watch your director. Now, Jack, you know, on your solo like that, I noticed that you were sort of like staring at our table, okay? Now, it's a little bit of a performance element that I want you to think about. If you can relax, okay, this is the hardest audience. You know, playing in a hometown is going to be your hardest. Remember, in Grand Rapids, you're not going to know everybody. You're not going to be able to see them anyway. So remember to look up and just, when you have those breaks like that, smile. Okay?
I'll be in Grand Rapids. You go eat. We've known each other for a while. Straight beast mode, right? I mean, great work, great work. I like this because they say all this stuff that's important, and then I just get to talk about weird stuff, which is fine by me. There were a couple things. Again, just some of those entrances, just together. I noticed it right before B, for a couple times where there was a little bit of staggering on some tonguing issues. So just the counting, the subdividing, making sure we're there. Love Sammy Nestico. It's Mike Hunter can probably blame him for that one. He drilled that one in me. One thing I did want to point out though, and this is a rhetorical question, I guess, but maybe you should think about it. What is the climax of the song? Because I felt like before letter D, four before D, there's that big forte, and then there's the stop, and then the last fermata right near the end before the cadenza, there's a triple forte, three Fs. But I felt like you guys were unsure which one you wanted to be the true climax of the piece. So maybe that's something, just mull it around in your head, which one carries more weight, because I felt they were about equal, and I don't know that they should be necessarily. And I don't know that there's a right or wrong answer, it's probably just, as a group, decide which one is the launch point that we want to hang this piece on, and that's the one that we should maybe bring up just a little bit more. That's okay.
Yeah, because I think that's